down. Financial markets are in chaos, and it's not over yet, not by a long shot. Basically, greed, dodgy loans, and bad debt are to blame. So you'd think we'd all be a bit cautious with our credit cards. Some of us may be, but not the kids they call Generation Y. They're young, reckless, and they've racked up an astonishing $60 billion of debt. New cars, new clothes, new toys, no problem. Just whack it on the card. These kids have never known tough economic times, so they think they're invincible. But now, they're in for the shock of their lives.
The world economy is in free fall, on the brink of recession. But 20-year-old Amanda Nabulsi couldn't care less.
How much do you spend a week on your credit card?
$1,500.
And you don't blink at that?
Not at all. Nothing.
It's a lot of money.
It's all right. It's happiness.
Amanda's typical of Generation Y, those aged between 18 and 28. She still lives at home, has no bills to pay. She earns $35,000 a year and happily blows every cent.
Don't look at the price, really. If you love it, you love it. That's it. Get it. Don't have hesitations about it. Don't have second thoughts.
What, whack it on the card?
Yeah, and pay it off later. It's like a take-home lay-by.
Pretty amazing.
Today, she's unleashing a brand new credit card. Limit $5,000. Wow.
Beautiful.
Her age group is now known as Generation Debt, owing a staggering $60 billion.
Are there any coins or notes in your wallet?
5 cents.
And underpinning their attitude is a naive confidence everything will be okay.
What do you think older generations think about your attitude to spending?
We spend too much money. That's what they think. I get told off by old ladies about, you know, you're spending too much money. I mean, that's my concern, not anyone else's concern. Where I'm heading has got to do with me. It's got nothing to do with anyone else. You know, it's my bill, it's my debt, I'll deal with it. And if I can't afford it, I'll just, you know, go bankrupt.
Oh, I don't know.
This is a generation which is only going to know debt and no assets, and that's an extremely dangerous combination for an economy facing a global recession.
The world financial crisis has been caused by debt. Why does Gen Y keep spending?
Because it's just like having a car accident. You only stop driving irresponsibly after you've hit the wall.
This is my life, Pete. This is 70 grand's worth of debt.
21-year-old Zoe Zirkler has hit the wall. Big time.
There's an 11 grand personal loaner, 9 grand TV, a 10 grand car, there's a 2 grand credit card, there's a $1,000 credit card.
Just 3 years out of school, Zoe's on the brink of bankruptcy.
This folder is my life. This is who I am, what I do, this is me. 70 grand's worth of debt.
On a supermarket salary of about $35,000, got a car, a PlayStation, a state-of-the-art laptop, 2 huge televisions, and much more, all on credit.
When you look at all this paperwork, $70,000 worth of debt, what do you think?
Why? Why was I so stupid? Why wasn't I just happy with what I had? Sorry.
It's really got to, it's that bad for you.
Yeah.
They're destroying their future. They're not going to be able to afford to have kids. They're not going to be able to afford to have a home. You know, more than likely they're going to be on a pension. You know, and they should be set up for life. And we've squandered it on what, like a big screen TV and a flashy car? It's soul destroying.
Okay, that gives us a total of $25,000 worth of debt.
Ben Paris runs a debt management service.
This into my calculator.
This is their last stop. People with debt are calling here.
It's either this or bankruptcy.
He goes into bat for people like Zoe, trying to negotiate a deal with creditors. Business is booming.
Does it worry you, though, that you are getting 8,000 calls a year
from people your age in massive debt?
My age and younger, they're the ones that really worry me. I'm 26 and we're getting calls from 18-year-olds who just eligible for a credit card debt and they've got a $5,000 phone bill, a $5,000 credit card bill, you know, a $10,000 car loan, and they're 18.
I can see myself in this. I did!
What's fueling this crisis is ridiculously easy credit being offered to a generation who are used to getting what they want.
This is so exciting.
Amanda has only 22 cents in the bank, but she's preparing to buy a $60,000 car on credit.
It's really pretty.
It's breathtakingly reckless, but if it all goes pear-shaped, Amanda believes she's not to blame.
It's like I'm a celebrity. Hello.
Are you saying you're a victim in all of this?
We are. We're targets. We are targets of the bank because we know that they know that we're gullible. They know that, you know, anything they say will just follow. You know, it's just they're the leader and we're just, you know, the little people walking behind them. Give me money.
You're loving it. You could have sent the card back.
But I needed it. I need it for emergencies.
I think your definition of emergencies is different to my definition of emergency.
No, I'm loving it. I really am. It's fabulous.
What role does easy credit play?
An enormous role, because even if you only knew the good times and you're willing to be irresponsible, it takes an irresponsible lender on the other side to give you that credit. And I really don't blame the kids for this.
Economist Steve Keen says the bad debt Generation Y is accumulating mirrors the bad debt that's led to the global financial meltdown.
Haven't the banks learned their lesson from the subprime debacle?
They haven't learned it because they're still looking for the best possible margin, and the competitive pressures in the market mean that if they don't provide an irresponsible bit of credit card lending to some Gen Y, somebody else will do it, and they want to get hold of the fees and get hold of the high margins they get on those loans. Only when the whole thing goes belly up will they suddenly turn the tap off.